Hey, what's up, you guys? Craft Farms here. Welcome back to Taheton County. Today, we are going to pick up just about where we left off. I got a full mixer wagon of cracked corn here. I did dump one in already. We're going to dump a second one in. And then I have four loads worth in here in the bunker. And then we got our alfalfa and our corn stalks. So we're going to start off. We're going to grab this guy. We're going to throw those bales in the back. And we're going to go shred them in the barn. So let's see how much of a mess I can make of this. Bales don't usually like to go on very well. No? They gonna prove me wrong here? Perfect. There's one. Let's see if we can get this other one on here. That'll work. Get in here. And blow some bedding down for these cattle. I think two will be fine for the time being. And I'll have about 20 yards worth, a little more, so we'll see anyways what this second one does. We might have to go get two more. Out of the red, so that's good enough for now. Let's back on out of here. And then we're just gonna leave this. We're gonna leave our feeding equipment out. So that way we can get to it easily. So we'll drop that guy. And we're gonna hook on to this. And put our 84 back inside. I did get the bucket and loader unhooked. where'd it go? I know they take it. Am I too close, maybe? I think that's it. There we go. See where we're at. All right, so we got 24,000 of grain in there. So now we'll probably mix up two loads of forage for them, and then they should be set for a little while. Actually, I think we're gonna leave the 84 out because we're gonna probably lease ourselves a plow and look at getting that plowing done. Alright. Let's see what we can make happen here. I'm pretty sure once I get close to the mixer, it should show me what I got going on. I should turn this guy on. So one bucket is 20%. So if we do four buckets of corn, corn stalk, and then a bucket of alfalfa, we should have a decent mix to feed them. It's kind of what I'm thinking anyways here. That's exactly what we're gonna do here. Is we are going to do four buckets of the corn stalks, and then we'll throw in a bucket of hay, just so we can kind of try and burn through these corn stalk bales a bit. Feeling that this is gonna pretty well empty one bunk, which is fine. one more. We'll have this part of our mix. Grab us a bucket of alfalfa and we'll go feed that one and we'll come back and we'll probably make one more yet. It's not quite even going to take the whole thing. I think on this next one we might do 3 and then 2. Try and get a better mix going. All right, let's go feed this. Oops. We want to keep the mixer running. We don't have quite such a high mix going on like we do now. I think we should be able to fit 48,000 liters of feed in here, no problem. We got all kinds of room for it. So let's cut back by one bucket here and see what that does. I mean, I'm not really shooting for a perfect ratio, but I'll try and get it a little better for him. And we'll take a scoop out of the other bunk. And I'll fill it back up here at some point off camera. It's just too time consuming to do on video, especially right now. And we got other stuff we could be doing. Grab a couple buckets of alfalfa here. That's a little better. Now, let's see here. Let's go grab two more straw bales. We'll throw two more in there. Then they're satisfied for a little while. Oops. And now's the moment of truth. 'Cause I don't remember if this grapple actually works with the bales or not. It does. Alright. Perfect. Let's tip this one back over. Tip it back the way it's supposed to be. Okay, I'm gonna leave that there for a moment until we get done. kind of thinking that the combine might come out of the heated building and go over to our cold storage and go sit where our feed wagon and our processor were, and then we'll put the feeding equipment inside the heated building. That way it stays warm throughout the winter. All right. Cool, 48,000. Yeah, that's a pretty good amount. This should be set for a little while. We'll throw two more bales in there and we'll call her good. Or I should say two more straw bales, to be exact. Yeah, I think that's actually what I might do at some point is I'm going to pull that combine out, stick it in the cold storage, and where am I going here? And we'll put the feed equipment in the heated building. Then it can be inside in the heat for the winter time. This time. This a little easier here because otherwise I'm gonna fight this thing. That's the downside to it, is the physics of the game when it comes to bales are not good enough to work correctly, at least for this. Be nice if the cows actually moved out of the way when you pull in. Should get us into the green. Perfect. 30,000 liters of straw and 48,000 liters of feed. They are set and ready to rock and roll for a little while. Now we let the bulls get in there and get busy. We need some calves so we can make some money. Even though it's going to take a while. Gotta wait until we've got calves every year, so either a year apart, so that way every year we can sell off a round of older ones and we'll just leave this hooked up. And then this guy. Here for now, until whenever I get around to moving the combine around. And let's get a plow leased and get it hooked up so it's ready. Let's see here, what do we got for horsepower? We got 270 on this guy. 181 there. This one's 4 1/4, so I'm not really worried about that one. But I kind of want to stick with the 84, so we want to stay around 250 for a horsepower requirement if we can. Have anything that small. Yeah. Okay. Let's go with this guy. And then, I guess we'll bring the big dog out. Bring the big dog out to play. I even saw that coming. Figured I was way too close. Should've known. There we go. So, I think the first one we'll do is we'll go over here to 127 and 128. see what's in between them. If there's a bunch of trees, then we'll do some land clearing, I guess. But that'll be for another episode, so... we're just gonna get her moved on over here and ready, and then, next episode we'll start knocking out some fields and getting them put together. Alrighty. Well, folks, I think that's gonna do it for today. Hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Hit that subscribe button if you like what you see. If you have not done so already, be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. And as always, folks, we'll catch you all in the next one.